Hey everyone, this is Tapan Sharma here, and welcome to my new course about building a referral system with Laravel. So as you can see in here, this is the dashboard of the referrer, and a new referral code will be generated whenever a user registers on our system. So yeah, that is the configuration that we have implemented in this system. So as you can see, this is my referral code, and to copy that, I can manually select that and copy it, or I can click on this button that says copy link. So I'll go ahead and click on it, and as you can see, that was copied into the clipboard. And along with that, as you can see, we are also showing the referral stats, and here we are showing the number of visits along with the number of clicks a certain referral link has, and then we are also showing the conversions, that is how many users actually bought a subscription using our referral link. And then we are also showing the active referrals, that is the active subscriptions of users that signed up using our referral link. And then finally, we are showing the payouts, and these payouts are basically the commissions that are given to the referrers. So yeah, all of these data will be displayed on the referrals dashboard. Okay, so let me quickly go ahead and demonstrate the whole flow of this referral system. So I've already copied the link, and I'll open that up in a new tab. So let me go ahead and paste it and hit enter. And as you can see, as soon as that page is rendered, it says that we have been referred by admin, and we are technically signing up with our own link, and we are doing this for demonstration. And when someone clicks on this link, then on the back end we will set a cookie for this user, and then we will redirect that user to the registration page, and from there they will create a new account, and then they will be redirected back to the dashboard, and from there they can buy a subscription. And if they do, then the referrer who referred this link will receive a commission, and that commission can be configured on our referral system. So yeah, we'll be looking at all of those stuff in this course. So yeah, let me go ahead and click on this link, and since we are currently logged in, we will be automatically redirected to the dashboard. So yeah, let me click on this link, and as you can see, I'm redirected to the dashboard, and here we have a plan that says monthly, and the amount for this monthly plan is $100. And for the payment, we will be using Stripe. And if you have a requirement where you need to choose any other payment providers, then yeah, you can go ahead and do that as well. For this case, I'm using Stripe. So yeah, let me go ahead and click on this link. And as you can see, since we were referred by someone else, we are receiving a coupon that is gonna give us 20% off for a month, and the original price here is $100, and since we are receiving a coupon, we only need to pay $80. So yeah, everything is set up automatically based on a cookie. Okay, so let me go ahead and make a payment. So I'll enter the card details, let's provide in the CVC, and let's pass in the address. And before we do that, let's also go ahead and look into our database. So currently, as you can see, we don't have any active subscriptions, and again, to manage the subscriptions, we will be using Laravel Cashier. So yeah, most of the stuff is going to be handled by Laravel Cashier, and it's going to make our process really easy. Okay, so now that we have looked into the database, and maybe I also want to show you the referral payments. So we don't have any payments right now, and whenever someone buys a subscription with our referral link, we will go ahead and create a new record on this referral payments table, and we will do that using Stripe's webhook. So we will listen for some specific events, and whenever those are triggered, we will go ahead and execute some block of code to store that data into our database. So yeah, we'll also look at how we can integrate Stripe's webhook into a Laravel project. Okay, let me go ahead and buy the subscription using the referral link that I just copied. So I'll click on this subscribe button, and let's wait for that to finish. Okay, that's done. And now we are redirected back to the dashboard, and as you can see, we are subscribed to the monthly plan. And if we go ahead and look into the database, let's open up the subscriptions table, then as you can see, a new subscription was created for the user ID 1, and the Stripe status is active. So yeah, everything is working. And let's also go ahead and look into the subscription items. So as you can see, a new subscription item was created, and along with that, if everything is working properly, then a new record should be created in the referral payments table. So let's go ahead and look into it. And as you can see, a new record was created for the user ID 1, and from $80, as you can see, the payment total was $80. And from that amount, we are receiving a 20% cut, which technically means $16. And this will be available after a month. So based on that date, we will be generating a CSV, and then we will mail that CSV to the admin so that they can import that to a payment platform, and from there they can make the payout. So yeah, we'll be looking into all of those stuff in this course. And once we generate that CSV, we will set the value of this paid at column to the date on which the payment was made, and based on that we will be showing the historical payouts. As you can see, let's open up the referrals dashboard. And as you can see, we now have one conversion since we made a payment using this referral link. So yeah, we'll be looking into all of this in this course. And I believe that you'll learn a ton of stuff along the way. And as you can see, a new record has been displayed in here for the active referrals tab. And this was signed up on 2024-75. The plan was monthly, and we will be receiving the 20% cut from the actual payment. So yeah, as you can see, everything is working properly. And finally, this section will be populated once we actually make the payout. And at the end of this course, we will also look at how we can use a job to automatically generate a CSV. And we will be using the scheduler of Laravel to run that job on the first day of each month. So yeah, we'll be looking into all of those stuff in this course. And I believe that you'll learn a ton of stuff along the way. So yeah, that's it for this video. And if you like the content of this course, then I hope to see you inside the course.